Hello friends and my dear students, welcome back to my channel Phoenix Physics. Today we are going to learn circular motion. You know that the motion of an object in a circular path is known as circular motion. There are two types of circular motion. One is uniform circular motion, another one is non-uniform circular motion. Motion with constant angular velocity omega is known as uniform circular motion. Example for this uniform circular motion is motion of hands of a clock, motion of earth revolving around the sun. These are all the examples of uniform circular motion. Then what is non-uniform circular motion? In the non-uniform circular motion, the velocity changes with time. Here, example for non-uniform circular motion is Ferris wheel, roller coaster, then horse running in the race, then motion of the train, all are examples of non-uniform circular motion. How do you define uniform circular motion? When a point object is moving in a circle, it covers equal distance on the circumference of the circle in equal interval of time, then the object is said to be uniform circular motion. Second important point is, in uniform circular motion, it has centripetal acceleration. In non-uniform circular motion, it has centripetal acceleration and tangential acceleration. In our previous video, I have explained tangential acceleration. If you want to check out my videos, I have given the link in the description box. Our third point is, magnitude of velocity vector remains constant. You know that velocity is a vector quantity. It has both magnitude and direction. In uniform circular motion, magnitude of the velocity vector remains constant, but the direction changes continuously. Look at the diagram. Here, this is our velocity v. Here, this velocity is 5 meter second power minus 1. Here also, 5 meter second power minus 1. So, what is the meaning? Here, the magnitude of the velocity vector remains constant, but the direction changes. Here, the direction is like this. Here, the direction is in the left direction. Here, downwards. So, the magnitude of the velocity vector remains constant, but the direction changes continuously. That's all about uniform circular motion. Next one is non-uniform circular motion. Here, velocity changes in both magnitude and direction. Here, only direction changes, but here, magnitude and direction changes. For example, look at the diagram. Here, v is 5 meter second power minus 1. Here 10, here 15, here 20. So magnitude changes. Then direction, this direction is upward direction side, downwards. So the direction also changes in non-uniform circular motion. Next topic is centripetal acceleration. In general, centripetal means center seeking. It is always directed inward, which means it directed towards the center of the circle, like this. In one-dimensional kinematics, object with constant speed or velocity, okay, constant speed have zero acceleration. Do you agree with this? You know that A is equal to dv by dt, rate of change of velocity. Here, v is constant, right? So, obviously, A is zero. So, in one-dimensional kinematics, objects with constant speed have zero acceleration. However, in two-dimensional and three-dimensional kinematics, even if the speed is constant, the particle can have acceleration. If it moves along a curved trajectory, such as circle. So what is the meaning? If it is one dimensional kinematics means V is constant, A is zero. But in two dimensional kinematics, two and three dimensional kinematics, even though V is constant, we have one acceleration. That acceleration is known as centripetal acceleration. You know that in a uniform circular motion, velocity, the magnitude of the velocity vector remains constant. I hope you know that. Here, even though the velocity is tangential at each point of the circle, the acceleration is directed towards the center of the circle. This acceleration is known as centripetal acceleration. So here I have taken two radius. So this is my center. Here from this center to this portion, say this is A and this is B. O to A, the radius is R1. O to B, the radius is R2. These two radius vector make an angle theta. We can say either radius vector or position vector. So here initially the particle is at A. After some time it moves to B. So the distance between O to A is R1. R1 is nothing but radius of the circle. The distance between O to B is R2. Here R1 and R2 are called radius vector or position vector. Theta is the angle between these two position vector. Here at A we have V1 velocity, at B we have V2 velocity. Just draw this V1. This is my V1, right? And this is V2. So connect these two. This is del V. These two velocity vector make an angle theta. So what is this delta V? Change in velocity. Final minus initial velocity. So final velocity is V2, initial velocity is V1. So this is nothing but change in velocity vector. This del V is change in velocity vector. Similarly, I want to find out delta R. Which one is delta R? This is R1 and this is R2. This portion is our delta R. Okay. So what is this delta R? Displacement. Displacement from A to B. Or we can say from R1 to R2. That is equal to final minus initial, that is R2 minus R1. You know that radius is also a vector quantity. Magnitude is same, but the direction is different. That is why I put vector sign here. Consider this as a uniform circular motion. So magnitude is constant. R1, R2, you can simply write R. Why? Because we are taking only magnitude. That is why I didn't put the vector notation. Same way for velocity, V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V. Here from this triangle, which triangle? Triangle OAB. From this triangle, how do you find out theta? Theta means arc length divided by the radius. What is this theta? Angular displacement. You know the formula, arc length divided by radius. Which is our arc length? Delta R is our arc length. Then what is radius here? R is our radius. You name the triangle as PQR. Instead of here R1, but you know that R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R. So you should write R, delta R by R. Here the triangle OAB and the triangle PQR are similar triangle. If it is similar triangle means we have already learnt one rule, that is the ratio of base length to the side length of one triangle is equal to that of other triangle. This is our base length, delta R is our base length. So delta R divided by R, that is equal to, here base length is delta V by side length is V. Actually V1, you know that either v1 is equal to v2 is equal to v. That is why I put v here. What about the direction? Here the delta v direction is opposite in this direction, so you should put negative sign. So the negative sign indicates it is radially inward or towards the center of the circle. From this equation you can easily find out delta v. What is delta v? That is minus v delta r divided by r. This is our delta v. We know that A is equal to del V by del T. Instead of del V, you can substitute the value. So what is that? Minus V delta R, here R del T. I have just substituted delta V value in this A formula. What is this delta R by delta T? It is nothing but rate of change of displacement. Rate of change of displacement is nothing but velocity. Right? So instead of this del r by del t, you can substitute v. So A is equal to minus v squared by r. This is our formula. You know v value. So v is nothing but r omega. We have already studied this expression. This v is linear velocity. This omega is angular velocity. So instead of v, you can substitute r omega minus r omega the whole square divided by r. So minus r square omega square divided by r. Cancel this, you can get the equation as A is equal to minus omega square r. What is this A? This A is nothing but our centripetal acceleration. What is the conclusion in this topic? First one, circular motion cannot exist without centripetal acceleration, which means no centripetal acceleration means the object is not moving in a circle. Second point, the magnitude of the velocity is constant. You know that magnitude of the velocity remains constant, but the direction changes continuously. Then third important point, centripetal acceleration is always directed inward like this. So centripetal acceleration is always inward, which means towards the center of the circle. Next one, centripetal acceleration is perpendicular to AT. Here, what is this AT? Tangential acceleration. So this is our centripetal acceleration, means this is our tangential acceleration. The angle between these two are 90 degree. That is why centripetal acceleration is perpendicular to AT. In this topic, we have studied what is centripetal acceleration. How do you derive centripetal acceleration relation in terms of angular velocity? A is equal to minus omega square r. We discussed about four important conclusions. I hope this video is useful to you. If you like my video, please share and subscribe my video. Thank you.